Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dr. Nikhat Banu, third year radiology resident from MGM Medical College and Hospital, Aurangabad. The topic of my paper presentation is computed tomography evaluation of complications of pancreatitis. Now, as we all know, acute pancreatitis, it is a disease with high morbidity and mortality with an unpredictable course. It has broad spectrum that varies from mild to severe forms with significant focal and systemic complications. Severe pancreatitis is characterized by a protracted clinical course, multi-organ failure, and pancreatic necrosis. The majority of patients with mild disease recover completely. However, 15 to 20% of patients develop clinically severe acute pancreatitis with local and systemic complications. Now, the CT is the gold standard for evaluation of pancreatitis because it is a non-invasive method of evaluating the morphology of pancreas and peripancreatic regions, as it is not affected by gas distension and obesity. CT severity is most important during the initial workup of acute pancreatitis, and therefore various CT scoring systems are available. CT severity index developed by Balthazar and Mortel are used, and a total score of 10 points is done. Computed tomography scan with IV contrast agent is required to determine the presence and extent of pancreatic necrosis as well as inflammatory changes, local and extrapancreatic complications. The aim of this study is to determine the role of computed tomography in early diagnosis of acute pancreatitis and to evaluate the complications using modified CT severity index to assess the severity of acute pancreatitis. Now, the materials and methods were, this is a prospective observational study, and it was carried out in 60 patients over a period of 2 years. All the patients who were suspected of having acute pancreatitis on clinical findings as well as on ultrasonography, and the patient who presented as acute on chronic pancreatitis were included in the study. The exclusion criteria were deranged renal function tests, patients with sensitivity to iodinated contrast media, and suspected acute pancreatitis patients with normal pancreas on CT scan. Examinations were performed on 128 slice CT scanner, and a contrast enhanced CT scans were obtained after IV injection of 80 ml of non-ionic contrast medium. Triple phase scans were obtained, and scan delay for arterial phase of 20 seconds was used, venous phase of 60 seconds, and pancreatic parenchymal phase of 35 seconds was used. The modified CT severity index is as follows. 0 points are given for normal pancreas, 2 points are given for inflammation of the pancreas or the peripancreatic fat stranding, and 4 points are given for pancreatic or peripancreatic fluid collections. Now, for less than 30% of pancreatic necrosis, 2 points are given, and for more than 30% of pancreatic necrosis, 4 points are given. Pleural effusion, extra pancreatic complications are given 4 points. Now, a score of 0 to 2 is it is graded as mild pancreatitis. 4 to 6 is graded as moderate pancreatitis, and severe pancreatitis is graded by total score of 8 to 10. Now, these were the results of our study. When the 21% of patients showed normal size of the gland, and 41 patients showed diffuse enlargement of the gland, whereas 36% percentage of patients show focal enlargement of the gland. Edematous pancreatitis was obtained in 25% of patients. Less than 30% necrosis was obtained in 16 patients, and 4 patients showed more than 30% of pancreatic necrosis. Peripancreatic fat stranding was the commonest finding, and it occurred in 90% of patients. Peripancreatic fluid collection was obtained in 78% of patients. Now, the focal enlargement was observed in 22 patients, out of which head and neck was the most common area involved. Commonest site of fluid collection was the lesser sac. And it fluid collection as well as pseudocyst formation was the lesser sac. The extrapancreatic complications site is pleural effusion, splenic vein thrombosis, portal vein thrombosis, and pancreatic or pleural fistula. Only one patient showed the fistula formation. We observed mild pancreatitis in 29 patients, moderate in 18, and severe in 13 patients. Patients with severe pancreatitis required intensive care management. Now, in figure 1, we can appreciate that there is diffuse non-enhancing area involving the pancreas as well as peripancreatic fat stranding and fat stranding in the right parapolic gutter. This suggests of pancreatic necrosis. Now, in the figure 2, we can appreciate that there is a fluid collection, a well-defined fluid collection with thin margins in the lesser sac region in a patient of pancreatitis. This was a pseudocyst formation in the lesser sac. Now, we can also appreciate there is a hyperdense area in the spleen, wedge-shaped, suggestive of splenic infarct because of splenic vein thrombosis. Now, because of proteolytic effects of the pancreatic enzyme on the various vascular structures, this results in erosion and formation of pseudoaneurysm, the thrombosis arising from the branch of the right hepatic artery. Here, we can also appreciate a pseudoaneurysm formation of the splenic artery. Now, acute pancreatitis, it is defined as the acute inflammatory process of the pancreas that may involve peripancreatic tissues and remote organ systems. Acute pancreatitis is divided into into acute edematous and acute necrotizing pancreatitis. Acute edematous pancreatitis consists of diffuse or localized enlargement of the pancreas due to inflammatory edema. And necrotizing pancreatitis occurs due to necrosis of pancreatic parenchyma, peripancreatic tissue, or both. Contrast enhanced CT scan shows patchy non-enhancing areas because of necrosis of the pancreas. Local complications can be parenchymal necrosis. It could be sterile or infected. Pancreatic fluid collection, peripancreatic fluid collection, pseudocyst formation, involvement of contiguous organs, vascular complications, or obstructive jaundice. The main purpose of CT is to assess the severity of the disease. Now, we observed that there was no association between the age and gender with severity of pancreatitis. Percentage of necrosis and severity of pancreas is higher with alcoholic pancreatitis. Pancreatic necrosis seen as focal non-enhancing lower tenesian area, therefore 16 had less than 30% of necrosis and 4 had more than 30% of necrosis. In this, we can appreciate that the most common site of extrapancreatic phlegmon, like pseudocyst formation, was the lesser sac region followed by left anterior pararenal space. We observed 29 patients with mild pancreatitis and 13 with severe pancreatitis showed the lesser sac formation. The extrapancreatic complications are the major cause of morbidity and mortality in pancreatitis. The splenic vein thrombosis of the pancreatic tributaries of the portal vein as well as the splenic vein was occluded in 45% of patients with pancreatitis. Vascular complications can lead to life-threatening hemorrhage due to arterial erosion and venous thrombosis. And therefore, splenic artery, pancreatic or duodenal and gastrodenal arteries are most commonly involved in acute pancreatitis. CT helps in diagnosis of pancreatitis as well as identify the fluid collection in patient with hemorrhage, determine the extent of inflammatory process and its proximity to important vascular structures. Now, we noted pseudoaneurysm formation with thrombosis of the right hepatic artery as discussed in figure 3. Pseudocysts, which were encapsulated collection of pancreatic fluid, were seen in 29 patients and 14 and in 14% it was located in the lesser sac. The CT scores were classified into 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. The maximum patients were seen with score of 2 and 4 and minimum with score of 8 and 10. Moderate pancreatitis was observed in 30% of patients. So to conclude, contrast enhanced CT scan of abdomen in acute pancreatitis has been differentiating between acute edematous and necrotizing. It has to predict the possibility of developing local and systemic complications. Ultrasound of abdomen followed by CCT helps in early and better anatomical delineation of complications of acute pancreatitis. It has been better treatment planning more effectively, accurately, and early. Mild to moderate pancreatitis, octus process can be managed conservatively, whereas a higher score requires intensive care management. Thank you. These are the references. Thank you.